So now let's proceed to the examples in your book. So I tried to take a picture, balag hiwi-hiwi. So just ano lang, follow lang in your book. So we have an entity owned a tract of land costing 800,000 and sold the land for 1 million. So the value of the land when it was sold would be 1 million, but in their records it was bought for 800,000. The entity received, so pagbaligyan niya, the entity received a 3-year note for 1 million plus interest of 12% compounded annually. Okay, so are you familiar with the term compounded? So when we say compounded, the principal will be multiplied by the interest rate and you will get the interest. For example, 100 and then the interest is 10%. So 100 times 10%, that's 10. What will happen is that the next principal that you are going to use would be the original 100 plus the 10 peso nga interest we have computed. So, diba, 100 times 10%, so that's 10. Then, 100 plus 10, it becomes 110. So, ang 110, mauna na po na siya, himoni mong next nga principal. So, 110 times 10% na sad to get the new interest. And the interest now would be 11. So, ang 11, i-add na sa nimo atong 100 o katong first nga interest nga 10. So, your new principal now would be 121. So, nga na ang compounded, it means that your interest manganak na sad og bagong interest, okay, basta i-compound. If it is simple interest nang na siya, it means nga i-multiply nimo tong 10% nga akong gi-example, i-multiply it by the original principal which is 100 and that would be the regular interest. So diba 10% times 100, that would be 10. So every year tag 10 na gyud ang interest. So, dili siya madugangan, dili siya ma-increase. Kaya ang interest, kung simple interest method ang gigamit, it will not be added to the principal. Therefore, there will be no new principal. So, same lang ang principal every year, that's 100. So, in a year 1, the interest would be 10. Year 2, interest would be 10 gihapon. And year 3, it will still be 10 if simple interest method. But if we're using compounded interest, okay, compounded interest, so sa akong gi-mention gani ha, for year 1, the interest would be 10% of 100, so that would be 10. And in year 2, mausap naman ang imuhang principal, mahimo naman 110 times 10 asad, so mahimo siyang 11. So, sa year 2, mahimo siyang 11. And ang 11, i-add na sa adtong 110 and you multiply it by 10. So, mahimo siyang 121 times 10%, mahimo siyang 12.1. Okay, sakto ba siya? 12.1. Okay. Check sana ako. Okay, so 12.1 na mahimo niyang interest. So, lahi-lahi yung interest every year and mag-anam siya kadako. Okay, basta compounded. So, let's go to the problem. So, if it's compounded, it means that any accrued interest also earns interest. So, the selling price of 1 million is reasonably assumed to be the present value of the note because it is interest-bearing. Remember, pag interest-bearing a long-term note, saan ganito siya pag measure? So, balik ko na to. Okay, if it is a long-term, kay long-term is siya kay 3 years man. So, if it's interest-bearing, you're going to record it at face value. Diba? Katurang non-interest-bearing, kung katurang mag-compute sa present value, which is a discounted value, kung non-interest-bearing. Okay? So, since this is interest-bearing, how would we know, ma'am, nga interest-bearing na siya? Okay, of course, mo na siya heading sa illustration. And aside from that, if the problem does not state it is interest-bearing, so you can look at the statement and you can see there's an interest rate. If there's an interest rate plus interest, so therefore, this is interest-bearing. So, what would be the entry? Debit note receivable, 1 million. This is our consideration for the land. And credit land for 800 because we have disposed of the land. So, i-credit siya. The difference would be the gain on sale of the land. Okay? Next, since it's compounded annually and it did not state if regularly we can receive installments, di ba? Wala man siya niingon kung na ay i-divide ba ni mong 1 million by 3, so mag-anam-anam magbayad. Wala man siya niingon. Ingon naman siya 3-year note, so this would be considered as a term note. What is a term note? So, with terms, of course, and then wala siya yung series of payments. Okay, so lump sum lang siya at the end of 3 years. So, therefore, we can compute the year 1 interest. So, to compute for the year 1 interest, we'll base it on the principal na 1 million and you multiply it by 12%. So, that's 120,000. So, debit, accrued interest receivable. So, why is this accrued? Because it is not yet collected. Wala man siya statement here that there was a payment being made or collection being made with regards to the interest. So, wala man siya nadawat nga interest payment. So, imuha na siyang himuong interest receivable. So, credit interest income, meaning you have already earned 1 year interest, which is 120,000. So, that's for year one. For year two, we still haven't received any principal payment because wala may instruction here. And we also did not receive any payment for the interest. So, we will record another interest receivable and credit interest income. So, to compute for the interest in the second year, so we will start with the original face amount. So, the original face amount here is 1 million. And then, we're going to add the interest in the last year based on the computation. So, that's 120,000. Okay, that's computed earlier. And we add that to get the new principal that we will be using to compute for the new interest. So, 1,120 times 12%, that would be 134,400. So, debit interest receivable 134,400 and credit interest income 134,400. Now, we're on the third year. So, for the third year, this would be the last year of waiting for the 1 million note. So, what would be our entry? So, first is we need to determine how much is our collection with regards to this note. So, remember, we will compute again for the interest in the third year. And the interest for the third year is equivalent to the rate nga 12% times the principal for the third year. So, how do we compute the principal for the third year? So, that's original 1 million plus 120, that's coming from the first year interest. 134,400, that's coming from the second year interest. So, the total new principal that we're going to use is 1,254,400. And that will be the basis for our 12% interest for the third year. So, that's 150,528. you add them, this will be your total collection. So the total collection here would be the 1 million nga note plus the total interest for the 3 years nga 404,928. Okay, di ba maoni ang total interest for the 3 years. But if you will be asked in the problem, how much is the interest income in the third year? Kung third year ara atong isgutan, that's only good for 1 year. So the answer would be 150,528. But if you will try to compute, pila man ang ako ang na income sa sud sa tulo ka tuig nga nag nisugot ko nga notes receivable lang. Okay, ang ako ang madawat. So, ang tubo adto is 404,928. So, aside from having a gain on sale of 200,000, you were able to earn additional 404,928 for the 3 years nga interest income. So, naa naman tayo na record diri nga income for year 1, income for year 2, and income for year 3. So, dako-dako atong naginansyaan ni. So, debit cash, 1,404,928, credit note receivable, 1 million, and then accrued interest receivable, 254,400, and the interest income good for 1 year, that's for the 3rd year, 150,528. So, if you're going to ask, asa man siya gikan ng 254,400, ma'am, you need to close all the interest receivable because in the 3rd year, you will be collecting the accrued interest. So, muna siya nga gi-credit tong na-record na to nga accrued interest. Okay? So, that is the computation for the interest-bearing note. If you like this video, don't forget to click like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to be updated with the latest video lessons. Thank you for watching!